Okay, welcome back. All right, the final push here. We've talked about ions, we've talked about naming compounds, we've talked about polyatomic ions, and now we just need to talk about how to name compounds with polyatomic ions in them and how to write compounds with polyatomic ions in them. So here's the deal. The formulas with compounds for compounds with polyatomic ions are determined exactly the same way as those without. The charges still have to add to zero. That's the rule. Okay, there's a couple things that people always want to do with the polyatomic ions I need to caution you against. We never, ever break apart the polyatomic ions ever, ever, ever. So you're never going to, you know, break this into sulfur and oxygen. You're never going to do that. It stays as one whole unit. And it stays as one whole unit with the indicated charge. So you can think about this as just having a negative 2 charge, exactly like sulfide has a negative 2 charge. Okay? Sometimes you need parentheses. So let me talk about this. Let me talk about how to do this first. So sometimes you need parentheses because you may need more than one polyatomic ion. So if I needed, if I need in that case where I had iron hydroxide, right? If I need 3 hydroxides, I can't indicate it this way, right? I can't do OH3, right? Because then that looks like 1 oxygen and 3 hydrogens, and I can't do it this way because then it doesn't look like hydroxide anymore. We need to indicate that there are 3 hydroxide units together. So that's when you use the parentheses and the number afterwards. Okay. So, let's do a little practice. Let's work through this. So, I've got sodium and I've got sulfate. Now, the only really important thing here is that sodium has a +1 charge and sulfate has a -2 charge, right? So, I need, just like, remember before, if we did sodium and oxide, right? We'd get Na2O. In exactly the same way, I have Na2SO4, right? Now I've got magnesium and nitrate, right? It's unimportant. Again, this is important for the identity, for identifying as nitrate, this 3, but it's not changing the charge. This is an ion with a -1 charge, just like any other ion with a -1 charge. Magnesium and nitrate come together to make Mg, right, with a +2 charge. How many nitrates do I need to match magnesium? I need 2 of them to get a -2, NO3-2, right? Ammonium cyanide, NH4-CN, right? Okay. Okay, let's talk about naming now. Now, something important. I told you have to memorize the polyatomic ions, and there's a lot of, you know, eights and ites, and a couple of ides. But I don't want you to get mixed up. Don't forget what you already learned about naming monatomic ions. So what's a monatomic ion? It's an ion that is only one atom. Whatever its charge is, it's only got one atom in it. So while this is sulfate, right, and this is sulfite. Oops, nope, that's not sulfite. That's nothing. I have the charge wrong on sulfate. Anyway, let me start all that over. Sorry. While this is sulfate and this is sulfite, what is sulfide? Sulfide is S2-, right? Because it's the monatomic ion. S2-. And we know it's 2- because of the charge that's the charge it would have based on where it is on the periodic table. So what's chlorite? Chlorite, ClO2-, whereas chloride, oops, is Cl-, right? And the way you don't get this mixed up with something like cyanide or azide is that there is no element cyan and no element aze, so you're not going to think those are monatomic ions. Okay, having gotten that out of the way, the naming of compounds, ionic compounds with polyatomic ions in them, is very simple. Just as in before, remember I said the magic rule is always the same. You just name the cation, whatever the cation is called, and then you name the anion. So, here we go. What's the cation in this first one? Magnesium. Right? Now we need to stop and take... Stop. So this is a metal, right? We need to think of magnesium as a fixed charge or a variable charge. It is a fixed charge metal, so we don't need that number in that Roman numeral in parentheses. And then we can just go on and name the anion, which is carbonate. Right? Okay, next one. Naming the cation. Manganese. Right? Is this a variable charge or a fixed charge? This is variable charge. I'm going to need some number in parentheses, some Roman numeral, and we'll come back to that in a moment. Phosphate is my second one, so it's going to be magnesium something phosphate, right? Because that's what PO42- is. Okay, we got to figure out what the charge on manganese is so we can put the correct number in the Roman numerals. So I'm going to put PO4, right? Each one of them is negative 2. There's two of them for negative 4. Did I screw this up? No, I got the charge wrong. That's what's wrong with me. Phosphate is minus 3, which means together there, it's minus 6. Hey, there we go, that works. Which means that the manganese is altogether must be plus 6, and therefore, each individual is plus 2. Manganese 2, phosphate. Okay? Here we go. Iron. This is iron something nitrate, right? So each nitrate is minus 1. There's 3 of them, minus 3. So iron must be plus 3. Iron 3 nitrate. This last one is simply lithium oxide, right? We can sometimes encounter polyatomic ions where compounds where we have two polyatomic ions, like... Right? So this is ammonium sulfite. Right? We just named the cation, and then we named the anion, and that's all there is. Now we want to go back the other way. Right? Going back the other way is actually probably, well, I don't know if it's necessarily easier, but at least this makes everything easier. I want to again emphasize... these Roman numerals, remember, it's the charge on the metal. It's not necessarily one of the numbers down here. It's the charge on the metal, right? So, potassium sulfate. So we got to think about this. Potassium is plus 1. Sulfate is SO4, 2 minus. So therefore, it must be, K2SO4 to make it all neutral, right? We have a plus something that's a plus 1 and something that's a minus 2. So we need two of the plus 1s for every one of the minus 2. Next one, copper 2 nitrate. So it tells us, don't make the mistake of trying to look on the periodic table to find out what the charge on copper is. Right? It's given to you in the Roman numerals. Copper 2, that means it's copper 2 plus. And nitrate is NO3 minus. Right? So this means we have Cu... NO3-2. That is what copper 2 nitrate would be. Next one, ammonium. Ammonium is NH4+, and phosphate is PO4-3-, right? So we need 3 ammoniums for every 1 phosphate. And down here, aluminum thiosulfate. Aluminum is always 3+. And thiosulfate is... S2O3-2-, right? So, we need, right, this is one of those weird ones, so we're going to need two aluminums to get us a plus 6 and 3 thiosulfates to get us minus 6. So there we go. Hopefully that makes sense. This is the thing you should practice a lot. This gives students a lot of trouble a lot of times. So you really should be going over this and practicing this, because it can really be problematic. Okay.